It's time to get your Bible and it's time to learn more about God. Are you ready? Get your Bibles. I'll wait. You have your Bible? I'm just being silly. But get your Bible, let's put it up to our heart, and let's do our confession. Say what I say. Say, this is my Bible. I am what it says I am. I have what it says I have. I can do everything it says I can do. This is God's Word. It's talking to me. I love my Bible. Lord, thank you, Father, for this day. Thank you, Father, for all the people that are watching. I thank you, Father, that they will get everything they need to get from your word today and learn how to get closer to you, Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen. Have fun!
In the next video, these kids will be doing a skit. Chloe will be playing the part of Martha. Crystal will be playing the part of Mary. And that's not Mary, the mother of Jesus. It's a different Mary. And Tripp will be playing Jesus.
See, that's what I mean, Mary. God has a plan for everything. He even had a plan for Nineveh. And Jonah didn't see eye to eye with that. He went to Nineveh. But not after. He went to Tarsus. And God saw him on Tarsus. So they threw Jonah over. And then the
big... Mary, come and help me.
Martha, I want to hear what Jesus says.
Master, please tell her to come and help me. I have loads of work to do.
Martha, you're so worried. You don't need to be so worried about just everything. Mary has picked a very important thing that she needs to abide by, and it will not be taken away from her.
Our Bible story today is taken from Luke chapter 10, verses 38 through 41. Jesus and his disciples were traveling, and they stopped by at the home of Mary and Martha. Martha invited them into their home. And while they were there, Jesus began to talk. Jesus began to teach. Mary, her sister, sat down at his feet to listen to what he had to say. Martha was busy. Jesus and his disciples were there, and she wanted to make them comfortable in her home. She was preparing food. She may have been cleaning. She wanted things to be just right. But she was so frustrated that Mary was not helping her. So she comes in there. She says, Mary, are you going to let me do all this work by myself? And she looked at Jesus and she said, Jesus, tell her to help me. Jesus was friends with Mary and Martha and their brother Lazarus. So they knew one another quite well. And he looked at Martha. He said, Martha, Martha, you're so concerned about so many things. But only one thing is important right now. And Mary has chosen that thing. And I'm not going to take that away from her. So in other words, he said, Mary's sitting here listening to me. That's what she wants to do. And this is the best place for her. So I'm not going to make her get up and start fussing around over housework. Well, there's always things that need to be done. They are important. But the most important thing is that we make our ears available to Jesus. Remember our listening ears that my little friend is wearing here right now? We need to make sure that we put ourselves in a position to hear like Mary did. And so every day we read our Bible, we tell Jesus we want him to speak to us. We thank God for giving us the Holy Spirit to live on the inside of us and teach us and talk to us. We make sure that we get quiet and we take time to listen, like Mary did.
Do you remember how Martha was so obsessed with getting the housework done that she wasn't able to listen to Jesus? Remember in our skit how Mary tried to get Martha to sit down with her, but Martha was just too busy. And she was so busy that she wasn't able to listen to Jesus. And Jesus' words are more important than anything. Well, I want to ask you, have you ever been afraid? I've been afraid. Have you ever been so afraid that you haven't been able to listen to what's important? You haven't been able to listen to what's true? Sometimes you can be afraid of something that's not even real, and people are telling you it's not real, but you're so scared that you're not able to hear. Or have you ever been really mad at somebody and you pointed at them and said, they did this to me? Or have you ever been angry? Well, I have. Let's try not to let our emotions and how we feel get in the way of listening to what's true, what's real. Listening to Jesus' words and the Bible.
Matthew 7:24 says, "Everyone who hears these words of mine and puts them into practice is like a wise man who builds his house on a rock."
What a fun lesson! I really liked Trip and Crystal and Chloe's skit. It was so cute. This week, you're going to get a puzzle for your craft, and it'll come in an envelope like this, and I'll let it be a surprise. You open it and be surprised about what it looks like. And then you're also going to get this. It says, "I will listen when Jesus is talking." You'll get Jesus, Mary, and Martha, and you'll have to either tape them or glue them to your paper. And then you can put it on your fridge. It'll remind you of your lesson. It'll come in a packet just like this. You'll get it when you come to church. Y'all have a great week, and we'll see you next time.